Zelda Breath of the Wild is probably the best game I have ever played. Despite some issues I have with the game, the combat system is engaging and very fun. The shrines I think were pretty fun and decently challenging. It also runs surprisingly well on the Nintendo Switch despite being a less powerful console than its competitors. It's obvious that years of care were poured when making this excellent game. But what if the combat system could be used in a different way? That's right, I'm talking about how a Zelda Battle Royale would look like on the Nintendo Switch. So first, let's talk about the bow and shield, because those weapons would probably be the most useful in the game. While you're fighting someone one-on-one, you could have the option to parry if someone shoots an arrow at you. Parrying that same arrow would feel immensely satisfying to pull off. There would be, of course, different rarities for bows. For example, the Lino bow would be considered a legendary weapon, while a Boko bow would be a common weapon. The same would be applicable to both weapons and shields. I can see myself parrying at just the right moment and then attacking with my sword at my opponents. Also, you would have the option of flurry rushing an opponent. While you're flurry rushing, your opponent cannot move. If you decide to slow down time, it will only be applicable to you and won't affect your opponent. You would have 20 hearts when you begin the game. Losing all 20 hearts would result in a game over screen. Next, let's talk about ruins. Bomb ruins would work like they normally would. You would throw a bomb and make it explode, and it would deal about 4 hearts of damage. I hope that they don't patch the bomb exploit where you can travel a great distance by lining up bombs. If they don't patch it, it can be used for a great traversal. The stasis can make you pause for 1 second, and if you're near water, you can use the ice ruin. It could be useful when looking where a player is. Just like in Fortnite, you can use markers, but here you will be allowed to use up to 5 markers, being the ones already available in Breath of the Wild. Those are green, blue, red, purple, and of course yellow. I just recently bought the amiibo cards, and it would be cool if they added skins, and you could unlock them with amiibo or just buy the skins with money outright. The different game modes could be squads, duos, and solo play. I'll get more into that in a little bit. First, let's talk about the various modes of traversal in this theoretical Zelda Battle Royale. Traversal is very crucial because it will decide how long it will take before your next battle. Having many options means getting to your next battle quicker. They can add the Master Cycle as well as keep horses in the game. That would be so much fun. I could just imagine running around Hyrule on a horse shooting my opponent with a bow. It would be exhilarating. The glitch slash exploit of using carts to lift you in Breath of the Wild could also be used for great traversal, or just using the carts normally could get you a great distance. Revali's Gale, Urbosa's Fury, and Daruk's Protection can be obtainable items that you could collect multiple before using. Gears will also be obtainable to increase your maximum damage, as well as increase your maximum hearts. The chests will be like amiibo chests or other regular chests you will find in Breath of the Wild. A big game right now that has a similar art style to Breath of the Wild is Spellbreak. It's another battle royale and it's pretty fun. It's like Fortnite, but if Fortnite used superpowers instead of guns. It's a really unique concept, and I think a Zelda Battle Royale could even use some of their mechanics. The map kinda resembles Hyrule a bit in the old ruins. The towers, they look like the ones from Breath of the Wild. Speaking of, Nintendo has to let us talk to other players online. I know it seems like a pipe dream, but it would be really fun playing a Zelda Battle Royale with my friends. Nintendo can't stay in the past, because if they do, it's not gonna seem worth it if I can't play with my friends. I really recommend that Nintendo makes it free and just gets the money from people buying skins, because that would just be enticing to new players. They could make it exclusive to the Nintendo Switch, seeing as they probably won't get it to the PS5. But seeing how Nintendo has been buddies with Microsoft lately, they could get it on the Xbox and even make the Xbox look more appealing. seeing as they don't have games. Finally, let's talk about how this would all run on the Switch. Since it's going to be a battle royale, they should definitely focus on FPS. It has to run at 60 FPS or at least 45 to maintain a good experience. We can't have the same thing what they did with Fortnite on the Switch, where it's locked at 30 FPS and it dips into the 20s. That just brings the experience down significantly. I remember playing Fortnite on the Switch when it came out, and it was unbearable to play, especially in creative. At one point, you had the ability to capture footage with the button on the Switch, but now you can't in Fortnite because those captures lowered the FPS for a few seconds in the game. Even if it is the case on the Nintendo Switch, they should give us the option if we want to capture epic moments on my Nintendo Switch. Because if they don't, I won't be able to show my friends the insane bow shot I landed on my opponent in a 1v1 to get the victory royale. This would be especially disappointing if Nintendo decides not to give us the feature to people that don't have capture cards and want a decent video quality. Especially with the new online feature on the Nintendo Switch where you can now easily send video clips to your phone and straight to your friends. Now, more than ever, it would be easy to send that video to your friends and get them to play the game. Nintendo has already experimented with Mario 35, and they can make a decent battle royale if they really wanted to. The same idea could be implemented for Zelda's 35th anniversary that is coming up soon next year. It would be that one more surprising, wacky left field idea that Nintendo hits us with. Why waste so many years into making this big open world map if you're only going to use it in one game? This would very much bring Nintendo to the top in terms of battle royale games. They did this with Tetris 99, they did this with Mario 35, now Zelda is all that is left. So yeah, I really think Nintendo should go for this really epic idea. It would make the Switch sell a lot more considering how battle royales blow up these days. It has the potential for so many things like being Among Us and getting more Twitch viewers for Nintendo games. They wouldn't even have to pay streamers to play this epic game, because who wouldn't want to play a new Zelda Battle Royale? If Nintendo does this, they could overtake Fortnite itself and become the next big thing. This has been Tech Bassoon, and I really hope you enjoy watching. I'm a small YouTuber trying to make it into the real world. If you want to help my channel grow, please consider subscribing, as only 2% of my viewers are actually subscribed. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.